So this year at the NAB show, we thought we'd get out of our booth and interview some of the people that actually influence us to make better videos. So I'm here with Jevon Dovey. If you haven't seen him before, he's doing super, super well on YouTube with nearly 270,000 subscribers. So you're doing pretty well. Yeah. So if people, I'm sure most of our viewers know who you are, but if someone's under a YouTube rock and they don't know who you are, or haven't seen your channel before, can you tell us a bit about your channel and what people can expect on it?
Yeah. So do you want me to hold this or?
What not scale?
Okay. So essentially my channel is a mix of things. I do a lot of like filmmaking tutorials. I do a lot of product reviews, but that's kind of more recently I've been doing that style of content. I got into YouTube by doing vlogging and mainly adventure travel vlogging, because that's kind of like my passion. I like going out there and exploring the world, seeing new places and creating content around that. So that's where my whole YouTube channel was kind of born. And then I found that I enjoyed doing educational content and helping other creators, inspire other creators and get them out there shooting themselves. Mm-hmm. So my channel has shifted more in the last year. I've been focusing more on teaching other creators how to be successful on YouTube and then also what tools you need to be successful.
And that's a big question that we get asked a lot is, if you're starting out your YouTube journey, especially if you want to be kind of a traveler, where would you start? What is the kind of basic equipment that you think you need? I think a lot of people sometimes think they need tens of thousands of dollars worth of equipment. What's your opinion on that?
Most people have the equipment they need right now. So if you have a smartphone, you have the equipment that you need to get started. Now, if I was to boil it down to like four things, I would say you need to have your camera, whatever camera you're using, whether it's a smartphone, a gimbal, if you have DSLR, mirrorless, anything works. Honestly, to get started in this, you just need to record. So it doesn't really matter what you record on. A lot of people have started with phones as their beginning camera, and they've had very successful channels, and they've built it from there. So you don't need to worry about like having the best piece of gear to start. Besides a camera, I highly suggest getting audio. So whether you are in a situation where you have a lav on or just a microphone on top of your camera, that basically increases the production value and just makes people really engage with your content much more. If they have bad audio, they will click away pretty fast. In terms of some other products, a computer, if you're doing editing, you know, you can edit starting on your smartphone, but I highly suggest getting into a better editing software because it's gonna make your life so much easier and it's gonna make things just flow faster. And I think that's the key. A lot of people, when they start YouTube, it takes a lot of time and a lot of effort. And you get frustrated because you're not seeing the numbers grow. And what it comes down to is figuring out a system that works for you and just keep going after it.
Yeah. And I see that a lot. There's a lot of procrastination out there. I mean, we were the same, you know, for many years sort of doing continual work on YouTube because, as you say, the numbers grow very slowly. So what's your kind of top tips? When did it all change for you? I'm sure you must have started off and the growth was slow, but at what point did you see a massive change and what do you think helped that?
Yeah, so when I started out for the first year, I had like under 1,000 subscribers. So I took an entire year, I shot almost 200 videos in that first year, and my channel was like not growing at all. And that was mostly travel, adventure content. And the when it started to take off is when I realized that you have to use what YouTube is to your advantage, and that is it's a giant search engine. So as soon as you start thinking about your videos in terms of search, as a small creator, you can get new eyeballs watching your content that you wouldn't normally get. Vlog style content, if you're just kind of shooting like day in the life or a travel vlog, it's interesting for people if they know who you are. But if they don't know who you are, you need to get them onto your YouTube channel. So you need to think search. So what are people searching for? And if you're doing something, say like travel adventure, then you would need to do like, what are people looking for in this specific city? Are they looking for tips? Are they looking for, you know, how to get around? Like, start thinking in terms of research and what people are looking for, and then create your vlog style content around that.
And was there one particular video that really kind of...
Yeah, so for me, my big video that took me off was around the DJI Mavic Pro. So I got that drone, I started doing some videos around it, some tutorials on... Actually, I started with doing reviews. So I started just doing some reviews, talking about the features, and then I realized it was a popular topic. And it clicked for me that search is so important. And then I started doing more tutorial around drone content. So like how to, you know, 10 tips to fly a drone or 10 things to do with your drone and, you know, get better looking footage, like different ways to control the camera. That whole series that I did around the DJI Mavic Pro made my channel explode. And then from there, I basically took that model and I just keep doing different styles of content that are all research based, tutorial based, but then still have that travel adventure element to it, because that's what I like doing.
I think that's the great thing about your channel, is just so much to learn. How do you find all the time to teach people this amount of stuff, and what's kind of next for you, you know?
It's just one of those things, you just gotta keep going. So for me, like, I take it one video at a time. You know, I have a list of probably 100 or 200 videos that I want to shoot, and you don't have that much time to shoot all that. So I try to do one video a week, bare minimum, two if I have time, and then, you know, I just focus on creating that content and then move forward onto the next and keep going. And, you know, YouTube's one of those things, you just gotta keep getting after it. You can't stop.
Yeah. And have you had any big mistakes? Is there anything you kind of regret in terms of your YouTube journey at all?
Yeah, so I mean, probably the biggest mistake that I made was starting out as a vlog channel and just kind of trying to shoot all this content, but not actually looking at what my content was doing. So not digging into the analytics, not seeing where people are clicking from. There's just you gotta look at the data that YouTube is providing you, because there is so much information in that data. Now, you obviously don't wanna go crazy with it, but you wanna look and see, like, which videos are doing well and be able to, you know, continue making videos like that so you can grow your channel. I made 200 videos that were just kind of me throwing videos up there, and I wasn't really focused on how the video was created from beginning to end. I wasn't looking at my audience retention. I didn't see if people were actually finishing the video. I just was putting videos out there. And so one thing that people do is they just keep putting videos out versus, you know, focus on one a week or two a week and then dig into those videos and see what's working for you.
So keeping it consistent, keep going. And would your advice be, if you have a video that works, would your advice be to carry on maybe a series on that similar topic, or keep changing it around, or mix it both?
So in YouTube, the YouTube algorithm really rewards series, because the whole goal of YouTube in general is basically to get a viewer to binge watch content. YouTube wants to see that your video gets watched from beginning to end, and then they want someone to click another video after that, and that's called session time. So how long that person is staying in YouTube after they've entered through your video. And that session time is important, because the longer that you can get people to watch content, the more that YouTube's gonna push your videos up in the ranking system. You want people to watch all the way through, and yeah.
Yeah, cool. Well, thanks so much, Devin. It's been great to speak to you.
Cool.
You've also got a training series as well. Yep. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
So I actually just launched a new course series. It's basically how to do YouTube, like from beginning to end, all of the strategy, all of the digging into analytics, all of the search, everything that we've kind of been talking about. I take what I've learned in 3 years of doing YouTube, and I boil it down into like a 16-week training. So every week you get like something to work on, only one topic, one focus, so you don't get lost in all of it. And so I have that on my website, creatorfilmschool.com, and then that's where you can find all my courses, and I do different trainings around YouTube and filmmaking.
Ah, cool. Thanks very much. So make sure you check out that, especially if you're new to YouTube.
Yep.
Even if you're on YouTube and you just want to improve things, definitely check out that course, and make sure you check out Jevin's YouTube channel as well.
Cool.
So thanks so much for joining us today, and hope you enjoy the NAB show.
Thank you so much.
Cheers, thank you.
A really great interview there with Jevin. We really love his channel. And what did you learn? What did you take from that interview? Leave a comment below and let us know. But continue watching, because in the next interview, we're interviewing Ariel from the iFilmmaker podcast. It's such a great podcast. And in this, he tells you all about that. And if you're a freelancer, how to get more work. So continue to watch that video. And if you're a filmmaker and you want to edit much faster, check out editorskeys.com, where we have the latest shortcut keyboards and keyboard covers.